Hello friends, welcome back to the new tutorial of the AWS. Now you can see that the issue which we have to resolve is, let me go to that code level, control Y, save this, run this tutorial, control C. Okay, and if I go and just hit this one, so today we are going to solve the issue usernames with this one. Username cannot be of the email format since the user pool is configured for the email alias. So how to solve this issue? What I did wrong when created a user pool? So I will let you know in this video. So let's go and just check this one. First of all, I'm going to go and just create a new user pool and I will show you what exactly I have done wrong. So create user pool. Okay. So here, Cognito pool sign in options, choose the attributes in your user pool that are used to sign in. If you select any one attribute or select a username or at least one of the other attribute, your user can sign in with all the selected options if you want. If you select only phone number and the email, your user will be prompted to select any of the two sign in options when they sign up. Okay, so it depends on you whether you want to select with the username, email, or both. They can log in. Okay, so that's the reason that's the issue is coming up. So suppose I'm going to add just only the email, okay, and move to the next. Okay, Cognito defaults, no send SMS. Okay, delivery methods depends on you whether you want to go with that one. It's up to you. Sign up, self-registration, email address, select attribute. So here we can select the attribute what I need. Require attributes based on the previous, that is phone number and the email is required. Okay. And I will check with the first name or name. Here we have the name also. So where we have the surname. Surname you can add family name, this one. And middle name is the name of and name. This is the full name. Okay, so I'm selecting the name only. Okay, right? Next, send email with Cognito only. Okay, so here we need to select the anything you can add the email test@gmail.com. Okay, send SMS, create new, no existing. I'm going to select it. Okay, time SNS region you have to select. Next, pool name. Last pool. Okay, so I'm going to use this. This is the last that we have to configure. Okay, then public client. Okay, enter the client name, last pool. Okay, and don't generate it. Okay, next. Then I'm going to save this one, all settings, create pool, right? So here we have the last pool right now. I'm going to use this pool ID and check this issue is resolved or not. Let's go and just see this one. So here we have this pool ID, right? We have pool ID right now. Now we have a client ID. So where we go with the client ID right now, so we have the app integrations. So here we have the client ID. Go and just add it over here. This is client ID, right? And let's hit the API. We'll see. Okay, let's go and just check. This is invalid, whatever we have added over here. Okay, now send this one, email, name, and the password. Send it. Attribute did not contain the form of the phone number. That means phone number is missing. So we need to add this attribute. Let me go and just add this attribute over here. So here we have the sign up process. I think this is should be in app.js. I guess no, it's in the route sign up process. So here, no, this is not there. So where we have a Cognito user sign up pool. Let me wrap this because phone number is important over here. So I think go with the app routes.js first. Okay, then we will check with this one, verify code, sign up, email and the password. Where it is the sign up process? Because here I haven't added the phone number. That's the validation part, right? That issue is resolved because that we have email and name, email and username, email and the phone number. If we all check this one, so that I issue arises because it unable to recognize whether it should be a username, whether it should be email. Okay, so this is the different one. If I found it, I will solve that one. To result status, to login. Cognito.js, where we have this one. So let me check this verify code. New user. So here we have. So it's like here you can see that this is name, this is email, right? So what we have to push it over here, that is called the phone number, which I am not using it over here. So I'm going to add this phone number over here. Just you need to add phone underscore number, right? And here we have to add the value. I'm going to put the static value, right? Value plus 9186996. Okay, so I'm going to save this, run this application again, okay, and just hit this API. Now true, this user is created. Go and check user pools, last pool, then we have a users. Reload this one. This one, rajni@gmail.com, right? Use confirmation status unconfirmed. Okay, so this is how I'm able to create the user. I'm going to tell you about how to create the user incognito, verify, change password, all of these things. But before, I'm just fixing that issue. I hope you get understand how to fix that issue. Any doubt, any query in that, let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a great day.